Hi, my name is Amber Case, and I'm the author of a kid's book about technology. I'm really excited that I got to write this, and I'm really excited to read it to you today. This book is dedicated to my mom and dad and my backyard tree. This book is about helping grown-ups and kids learn about the role technology has in their life and the relationship with it. This is also a book about time, the value and quality of your time, and how you can spend it, and how the importance of achieving balance in our lives and with technology. But remember, technology is everything that we use in the world, from poetry to pottery, from books to your television. So my goal is not to take kids away from technology, but rather help them see the joys and benefits of spending some of their time away from their computers and devices and discover all that life has to offer. This is a kid's book about technology. But this book isn't about how playing with video games is bad, or how to keep you safe online, or why you should spend less time on your phone, or how to build a computer. No, this book is about how we feel when we use technology. Before we can understand that, we need to know, what is technology? Sometimes we think technology is just computers, but it's actually everything around you. From a seed to a tree, to a pair of glasses, to this book you're reading right now. A lot of technology works like a tool that allows us to do something useful or fun, like a hammer and a phone. They're both tools. But while technology is meant to help you, different kinds of technology can affect us differently. Especially newer technology like computers, cell phones, and other devices. That's what we're going to be focusing on today. You see, I grew up in a home filled with technology, so I know a lot about this stuff. You could even say it's part of my genetic code. My family built computers, synthesizers, microphones, and speakers. My aunt even made trailers for Hollywood movies. And my grandfather was even one of the first people to help build the internet. The internet! So I grew up building, making, creating, and learning with all kinds of technology. I played outside with the first technology, nature, trees, sticks. With the technology of the notebook, I would write and draw and make my own worlds. Then I got my first computer and took my exploring inside. To be honest, I love technology, but sometimes it can be lonely. That's the thing about technology. Sometimes you use it by yourself. Even when you're chatting, talking, or playing with someone else, you can still feel alone. Sometimes I would look at what others did online, and I felt like I wasn't smart enough. Sometimes I saw other people playing, and I felt left out. But other times I would use technology to learn new things and make new friends. That's the thing with technology. It can feel different depending on how we use it. Sometimes we use it for fun and to create. Sometimes we browse through the web even when we know we should be doing something else. Sometimes we use it to escape. Sometimes we use it to connect. And sometimes we use it because we don't feel like there's anything better to do. Sometimes when we use technology, we don't know when to stop. Technology isn't good or bad. What makes it good or bad is how and when we use it, and what we use it for. Even though the connected technology we use every day is made up of glass, metal, wires, and transistors, we can get out of balance in how we use it in our lives. And being out of balance affects our bodies and how we feel. Swipe up for an example. Have you ever lost track of time while staring at a screen? You were doing something, and then realize all of a sudden that you've been staring at your device for so long that your body is frozen up. You eventually realize 3 notifications. You're hungry. You're late for something. You're tired. Technology can sometimes be so consuming that we forget all about our bodies. But your body is a very special thing. Your body has needs. Your body needs to eat food. Your body needs to move. Your body needs a hug. And your body needs fun. No matter how hungry you are, your phone can't feed you a meal, or give you a hug, or make you truly happy. Our devices and technology seem like they're giving us those things, but in reality, they're not. They're just substitutes for the real thing. No matter how much time you spend sitting with technology, it won't give your body what it needs to stay strong. Your body still needs to walk around to keep working. This doesn't make technology bad. We just need to be careful about how we use it. How we use our technology is connected to how we spend our time. Do you ever think about time? The Greeks thought about time a lot. They thought about it so much that they actually had multiple words for it. I want to teach you those words. The first word is Kronos. Kronos time is when you have to do something you need to do and you have to make sure it gets done. Like when you have a doctor's appointment or the time you need to be in class. When you spend this kind of time, you might feel tired afterwards, but you also might feel productive and accomplished. The second word is Kairos. Kairos time is quality time. When you spend this kind of time, you might feel refreshed and inspired. Kairos time is going on a walk, drawing, or showing something we made to our parents or loved ones. Special ability unlocked, ancient Greek, level 1. Special ability unlocked, ancient Greek, level 1. Sometimes we have to spend Kronos time doing chores or housework. When we complete these, we feel better afterwards, but it can be hard to do. Kairos time is time we want to experience. Sometimes we might feel guilty when we use our Kairos time, so it's hard to remember to enjoy it. You might feel like there's too much to do or that it's easier to spend time on your devices. But we all need Kairos time, because Kairos time is human time. And we all need that. Kairos time allows us to dream and imagine. It reminds us that we're alive. One reminder, you're alive! But sometimes we get stuck in looping time. Sometimes we're upset about what someone said online and we can't stop thinking about it. Or we sit still for too long and our body hurts. Or we stare at screens for hours and our minds feel hazy and tired. You might be wondering, how do we get out of times like this? Times when we aren't feeling so great or forget we have a body. Here's a secret. Are you ready? You wiggle! Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle! That's right. You get up and you shake and you wiggle until you giggle. Go ahead. Try it. I'll wait. Do you notice anything different about a freshly wiggled body? Something about moving, bouncing around, and feeling your body go back and forth jumpstarts you into Kairos time. It puts you back into the here and now. It's like the ultimate reset button. When you do it, you go back to choosing how you want to spend your time. Special ability unlocked, Wiggletastic Moves, level 2. So instead of feeling stuck watching videos for 4 hours, you can choose to just watch 1 or 2. And then invent a whole new world in your notebook. Or spend time on a walk, exploring your neighborhood, looking at new buildings and plants. Special ability unlocked, advanced mindfulness. Not all time spent on technology is Kronos. And sometimes Kairos time involves different kinds of technology, like trees. Remember, technology isn't all bad, but we need to remember to feed our bodies as much as we feed our minds. So next time we're feeling stuck, tired, or just out of our bodies and we want to change it, remember, there are many ways we can feed our bodies. Not just with food, but with taking deep breaths and fresh air, with movement and with big hugs. That's the end of the book. The outro says, technology affects all of us. Sometimes in positive ways, but in other times not so much. We have to remember, sometimes when we look at technology, we're really looking for belonging or comfort. But we don't need technology for that. We can give that to each other by spending quality time with those that we love. So, here are some things you can do with your kids to get away from your devices for a bit and put yourself back in balance. Throw a ball, have a dance party, share a meal, go on a walk. Play with a pet together, talk and listen to each other, and don't bring up work or things they need to do. Find more kids' books about lots of different subjects like community, diversity, gender, autism, adoption, emotions, climate change, addiction, sexual abuse, suicide, and immigration at akidsbookabout.com. Thank you very much. It's been great being here today with you, and I hope you enjoy the book.